Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pollin. This week I'm going to show you how you can link your calendar to reminders. Now, I've seen this a lot in the comments where people said, I wish I could link reminders to calendar. Well, the answer to that is yes, you can, but not in the way you probably are thinking. Now, there is a problem here, and I really want to address this before we get into the video, and that is, if you have a list of tasks in your reminders, and you also have the same tasks in your calendar, then you have duplication. Now, the problem with duplication is, at some point, you are going to miss something. And normally we rely on one app or the other as our main source of what to do next. So for example, if you collect all your items in reminders and then you want to link that to your calendar so that you can see all your reminders, you are not going to trust one of them. Either you're not going to trust reminders or you're not going to trust calendar. And your productivity system, I promise you, will collapse. No matter what you're thinking right now, I have seen this time and time again. When you create duplication, you create gaps and holes in your productivity system, and inevitably things will slip through. But if you're still determined to have your reminders on your calendar, then there is a way that you can do it. Now, you can do it brilliantly on the iPad. Now, I've not found a way of doing it on the iPhone, and I've tried this on the Mac, and as of Mac OS, whatever the current version is, Catalina, you can't do it. Maybe we'll be able to do it in Big Sur when it comes out. If we can, I will do a video on that. So let me take you into my reminders and calendar on my iPad and show you how you can do this. It is actually a great planning tool. But as I say, you do not want to be doing this really too much because you are going to create duplication, and duplication always leads to things slipping through the cracks. Let me take you into my iPad now. Actually, before we do that, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Apple as a productivity system, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, I really will take you into my iPad now and show you how you can do this. Okay, so let's get started with the first thing. What you want to do is you want to open up your calendar. Now, here is a demo calendar of mine. Now, the next thing you want to do is open up the Reminders app. Now, the way I like this, my personal preference is to drag it up to here so I can move this around the screen. I can move this over here if I wish, which is great because this is on Thursday. So what I'm going to do here is let's have a look at what I've got on my list of work that I need to do today. So I've got to work on the presentation for next week. Well, I need to do that now. So I'm just going to drag that. I'm just going to drop it into my calendar there. This is set up now for 10. I actually want to set this up for 10:30. So I'll just drag that down to there. So that should be 10:15. Oh, we're going to drag it a little bit further down to there. That should be, yeah, there we go. So it's now set up for 10:30. I'm going to do that. I'm just going to add that in. Now, normally you would have maybe different colors for this. I'm just using one specific demo calendar. I don't want to show you all my private events. So you would probably have different colors for this. So I've got to pick up Oscar from rugby practice. So I'm looking at that. I need to do that around about 5 o'clock. So I'm just going to move that over there. So, yep, I'm just going to grab this, drag that down. I want to do that at 6 o'clock. Sorry, I need to pick that up at 6 o'clock. So just drop that there. I can move this back over here, over there, and just add that event. So I'm picking Oscar up from rugby practice, and then we have dinner. I need to get my admin set up before I finish work today. So I'm just going to move that. So looking at my end of day here, so I'm just going to drag this one, drag it down there. I'm just going to put that one right there so I can do that. I'm going to add that in. So, oops, just want to drop that one a bit further down. There we go. Get all my admin up to date. So that's been added. And I've got to record the podcast, and I've got a really nice big block of time after my exercise. So I'm just going to move that one and do that after exercise. So that one's done. Maybe I need a little bit longer for that. So I'm just going to drag that down to there. So this is from almost 2 hours to do that. And that's it. That's my week done for the, that's my day planned. Now you can do this, of course, for your weekly planning, or you can do this for daily planning. And it's just a really super way of bringing in both your reminders and your calendar, seeing your events and looking at where you can start doing those tasks. Remember, you can't change the fact that you've got 24 hours in the day, but when you use your calendar for your planning sessions, you get to see just how much spare time that you have each day to do the work that you need to do. And this is a super way of using Apple's reminders and iCal or Apple Calendar to be able to plan out your day. So there you go. I've got my day planned for today, so I better get working because I've got a presentation to finish for next week. Thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.